All right, first and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory that's due to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Raka, Kodash. All right, which simply means all praises to the Most High God in his true name, which is Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai, which is the true name of the Savior of the nation of Israel. This is who the world calls Jesus, but his true name is Yahweh Shai, in the name of the Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of Truth, which has been sent down from the heavens in these last days and times, as foretold in the book of John. The Lord said that he would send us the comforter. He would send us another comforter because, you know, we were comforted when the Lord was with us in the flesh. And so the other comforter that he sent us was now, which is the Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of Truth, which is guiding us and giving us understanding to break down these holy scriptures in their truest, purest form. All right, double honors to the elders that rule well, which are the men that taught me this truth, beginning with the elders, apostles of Great Millstone. Salutations to the men teaching this word in truth, sincerity, and diligence. Shalom to you, brothers, and shalom to the believers that are hearing our testimony and believing in faith and obedience as well. In this video, I just want to talk about, I want to go into Deuteronomy, with the law surrounding the damsel, all right, because everything is spiritual, and I want to tie this into today, all right, with this whole, mandatory vaccinations that's coming around the corner, and the RFID chip, microchip coming around the corner. I want to start here, Jeremiah 6 and 2. I have likened the daughter of Zion to a comely and delicate woman. All right, let's check another translation on that and see what that says. NLT, O Jerusalem, you are my beautiful and delicate daughter, but I will destroy you. NIV, I will destroy daughter Zion, so beautiful and delicate. ESV, the lovely and delicate bread, I will destroy the daughter of Zion. Though she is beautiful and delicate, I will destroy daughter Zion. All right, so the children of Israel, man, which is Zion, which means monument, all right, the memorial of the Most High is are the Israelites. We represent the Most High on the earth. And he's compared us to a beautiful woman. All right, now let's go to Deuteronomy, the 22nd chapter. And I want to get this in the New King James Version. All right, so in the New King James Version, let's go start at Started at 22. If a man is found lying with a woman married to a husband, then both of them shall die. The man that lay with the woman and the woman, so you shall put away the evil from Israel. If a young woman who is a virgin is betrothed to a husband, and a man finds her in the city and lies with her, then you shall bring them both out to the gate of the city, and you shall stone them to death with stones. The young woman, because she did not cry out in the city, and the man, because he humbled his neighbor's wife, so you shall put away the evil from among you. All right, so the key word there is in the city. But if a, verse 25, but if a man finds a betrothed young woman, and betrothed means pretty much engaged or reserved for a man, you know, you belong to someone. But if a man finds a betrothed young woman in the countryside, and the man forces her and lies with her, then only the man who lay with her shall die. Okay? But you shall do nothing to the young woman. There is in the young woman no sin deserving of death. For just as when a man arises against his neighbor and kills him, even so is this matter. And verse 27 is going to tell you why. For he found her in the countryside, and the betrothed young woman, the woman who belonged to someone else, the betrothed young woman cried out. But there, and I could be breaking that word down wrong if I'm not mistaken, but betrothed does go into like belonging to somebody. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna just look it up real quick. betrothed, engaged to be married, a person who to whom is engaged to be married. Yeah. So, you know, in modern day terms, they would say someone who's engaged, you know, somebody's fiance, you know, but definitely someone who belongs to someone else. All right, so verse 27, for he found her in the countryside and the betrothed young woman cried out, but there was no one to save her. So there was no one in the countryside to save her. But when she was in the city, you know, if she would have cried out, somebody would have heard that and come to her rescue. But in the countryside, no one was there to come to her rescue and save her. So therefore, you know, she's in the clear. If a man finds so I wanted to tie that in because, you know, what's going on with this whole, you know, mark of the beast and, you know, the vaccine and everything, you know, this is equivalent to a damsel, which in the KJV, they use the word damsel. They don't use the word, virgin. They use a damsel. So, you know, that word sex pretty much goes into a cut. And what's happening is Esau is about to penetrate, you know, the nation of Israel, which is the Lord's woman. He's looking to penetrate the Lord's woman. Okay, he's looking to insert his stamp, his mark, into the Lord's woman. And so only the elect are going to be crying out. You know, again, going back to this law, are going to be crying out. And if you scroll up, verse Deuteronomy 22:20, but if the thing that is true and evidences of virginity are not found for the young woman, then shall they bring out the young woman to the door of the father's house, and the men of her city shall stone her to death with stones, because she has done a disgraceful thing in Israel, to play the harlot in her father's house. So you shall put away the evil from among you. And you got 2/3 of the nation of Israel playing the harlot. Okay, they have forsaken. Jeremiah 2:13, for my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewn themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water. All right, so you traded everything for nothing at all, man. You had it made, but now, you know, you had you a nice ass well, you know, good clean water, and you traded that shit for some goddamn city tap water. You know, shit got chlorine all in it. It's dirty. It's hard. Got, you know, calcium and all kind of minerals coming in it. You know, it stinks. You know, and by way of this whole chip and, you know, beginning with the vax, 2/3 are not going to be crying out. And that's going to cause them to get put to death. That's equivalent to you being, you know, in the city and not crying out, man. You know, so the Lord is looking at his woman as a filthy whore, and he's about to take her out and stone her. We just read the judgment, and I wanted to get this account. This is in the book of Susanna, which is just one chapter in the Apocrypha. It goes back to the time of Daniel, you know, in the time of Babylon. I'm just going to read the first few verses and scroll down. There dwelt a man in Babylon called Joachim, and he took a wife whose name was Susanna, the daughter of Chalcias, a very fair woman. And her name wasn't, now keep in mind, they had Hebrew names. So, you know, the Hebrew name, you know, look up the Hebrew name of Susanna. You know, her name wasn't really Susanna. It was like Shashanah, something like that. I don't know, something like that. All right, so keep that in mind. Her name wasn't really Susanna. That's English, or, you know, probably of a Latin background or something like that. The daughter of Chalcias, a very fair woman, a very beautiful woman, and one that feared the Lord. Her parents. And so today you're going to have women that have feared the Lord. You have women that feared the Lord back then. So the Lord, he can put the fear of the Lord on certain women. Her parents were also righteous and taught their daughter according to the law of Moses. Now Joachim was a great rich man and had a fair garden joining into his house, and to him resorted the Jews because he was more honorable than the others. The same year were appointed two of the ancients of the people to be judges. So basically two of the elders, such as the Lord spake of, that wickedness came from Babylon, from ancient judges who seemed to govern the people. And we'll jump down to verse 7. Now when the people departed away at noon, Susanna went into her husband's garden to walk. And the two elders saw her going in every day and walking, so that their lust was inflamed toward her. And then keep in mind, this is another man's, you know, woman. You know, you got these two elders lusting after somebody else's, you know, property, somebody else's wife. And they perverted their own mind and turned away their eyes, that they may not look into heaven nor remember just judgments. And albeit they both were wounded with her love, yet durst not one show another his grief, for they were ashamed to declare their lust that they desired to have to do with her. And that's gonna get real wicked, man. They basically gonna come to her and say, hey, matter of fact, let me get that. I'm gonna jump up to verse 20. Behold, the garden's doors are shut that no man can see us. And this is when they confronted her in the garden one time. You know, she was she went to go wash, and the maids that were with her, they left, and then they was in the cut, you know, peeping out, checking her out. And then when the maids left, they approached her and they closed the doors, and they basically said, hey, you gonna lay with us, you know, or we gonna tell a lie on you, you know. And with that lie, she would be worthy to be put to death according to the law. So I'm gonna read that real quick. Verse 20. Behold, the garden doors are shut. This is when they, I'll start at 19. Now when the maids were gone forth, the two elders rose up and ran into her, saying, behold, the garden doors are shut that no man can see us, and we are in love with thee. Therefore, consent unto us and lie with us. You see, if thou were not, we would bear witness against thee that a young man was with thee, and therefore thou didst send away thy maids from thee. So if you don't lay with us, we gonna lie and say that you lay with another man, which is adultery, which is a sin punishable by death. All right, so verse 22. Then Susanna sighed and said, I am straitened on every side, for if I do this thing, it is death unto me, right? And if I do it not, I cannot escape your hands. It is better for me to fall into your hands and not do it than to sin in the sight of the Lord. With that, Susanna cried with a loud voice. So she's that damsel now that's crying out. And in case you like, okay, where you keep getting this damsel thing at? Let's go back to it. Deuteronomy 22. Verse 23, you see, if a damsel that is a virgin be betrothed unto a husband, and a man find her in the city and lie with her. All right, so she's that damsel here. Now she's crying out. All right, back at 24. With that, Susanna cried with a loud voice, and the two elders cried out against her. Then ran the one and opened the garden door. So when the servants of the house heard the cry in the garden, they rushed in at the privy door to see what was done into her. And that's when these wicked ass niggas, they lied on her. All right, so going all the way down, you know, they basically, you know, had a little court, you know, and found her guilty. And then she called on the Lord, because again, it said at the beginning that she feared the Lord. So what did she do? She called on the Lord, and the Lord, you know, worked a wonder through the prophet Daniel. You know, let's get that. Let's see if I can find it. I'm just scrolling, looking for it. Right about here. Yeah, them niggas lied on her. All right, verse 40. But having taken this woman, we asked who the young man was, but she would not tell us. These things do we testify. This and they lying on her. Then the assembly lying on her. Then the assembly believed them as those that were the elders and judges of the people. So they condemned her to death. Then Susanna cried out with a loud voice and said, O everlasting God, thou knowest the secrets and knowest all things before they be. Thou knowest that they have borne false witness against me, and behold, I must die. Whereas I never did such as these men have maliciously invented against me. And the Lord heard her voice. Therefore, that's why, where the scripture at? First Peter 3:12, for the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. And we're about to see that right now. So he heard her voice. Therefore, when she was led to be put to death, the Lord raised up the Holy Spirit of a young youth, a young man whose name was Daniela, who cried with a loud voice, I am clear from the blood of this woman. And so basically Daniel stepped in, and now he influences, he gets them to examine the elders and see if their stories line up. And both of their stories are off, you know, after examination, and they find out that they were lying, man. And then they ended up putting their ass to death. All right, so that's that in a nutshell. Okay. Now, this is Revelation 12, verse 17, all right, because, again, we are that woman. The elect represent that woman that's crying out, and the two-thirds represent the damsel, you know, that's in the city and ain't saying a damn word, you know. Here it is, her man around the city. You know, she getting pressed on by this man, knowing that she got another man, and she ain't say nothing. She just, you know, letting it happen. She ain't screaming, she ain't resisting, she ain't saying no. Alright, this is Revelation 12:17. And the dragon, matter of fact, let me start at the first verse. And there appeared a great woman in heaven, a great wonder in heaven, Salakia, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her foot, under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. Those 12 stars represent 12 tribes, alright? This is Israel. And she, being with child, cried, travailing in birth, and pain to be delivered. And that child represents Yehoshaphat. All right. So, again, this woman is Israel, man. All right. Revelation 12:17. And the dragon was wroth. Wroth is a form of wrath. He had wrath with the woman. All right. And went to make war with the remnant of her seed. All right, the elect. All right, the scriptures always talk about the elect or the remnant of the house of Jacob. All right, and because when you look at, you know, the elite's plans, the only ones that's gonna stop them from fulfilling their plans through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemiyahushai is the elect, because the elect are not gonna bow and submit to the plans of the globalists, the elites. With this whole new world, you know, that they looking to push forward, you got resistance that's gonna come from, you know, other Edomites. But at the end of the day, it's the elect's resistance that matters. Alright, this is that remnant of the seed which keepeth the commandments of the Most High and have the testimony of Yahushua. Right, this is our testimony. Right, and the dragon is gonna try to come after us because we have the testimony that's gonna, you know, take this devil down and get his, put his ass in 1,000 years of hardcore slavery, followed by extermination off the face of the earth. All right, now this same scripture, let me see, cause, I know it's one in Daniel 2. Yeah, Daniel 7:23. Let's check that out. This is Daniel 7:23. Matter of fact, here it is right here. The book of Daniel 7:18. You know what? I'm Salakia. Let me start up at 17. These great beasts, which are four kings, which shall arise out of the earth, But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. Then I would know the truth of the fourth beast. And right now we in the time period of the fourth beast. All right, that was four beast or four rulerships that the prophet Daniel was referring to in his book, which was diverse from all the others, exceeding dreadful, whose teeth were of iron and his nails of brass, which devoured, breaking pieces and stamped the residue with his feet. Yeah, we in the most brutal of them all. We in the Roman Empire, which is the fourth beast. And, you know, the Roman Empire fell and was revived during what you call the Renaissance. And this is the new Roman Empire, right? The EU, NATO, and America. Verse 20, and of the 10 horns that were in his head, and of the 10 horns represent the 10, 10 nations, if I'm not mistaken, that come out of EU, goes back to Britain, the French, Spanish, Germany, Germania Minor, Germania Major, and there's others. I hadn't done the breakdown in a minute, so I'm kind of rusty on it, but I might have to dig into that soon. And of the other which came up, and before whom three fell, even of that horn that had eyes and a mouth that spake very great things, whose look was more stout than his fellows. And, you know, America is that had that look that's more stout than his fellows. You know, out of all his other comrades, America has that the most pompous, the most arrogant, you know, look about himself. About herself than everyone else, you know, within the whole beast system. Verse 21, I beheld, and the same horn made war with the saints and prevailed against them. Yeah, and the same beast is, again, about to make war with the saints. And, you know, this is when we're going to need the Most High to send the Lord back to come, you know, rescue his woman. Verse 22, until the Ancient of Days came and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High, and the time came that the saints possessed the kingdom. Yep, and that's what's about to happen. So this prophecy going all the way back to the time of Babylon, this hadn't even been fulfilled yet. All right, so again, the Lord is about to come, you know, get his woman. This is the book of Isaiah chapter 54, verse 5. It says, for thy maker is thine husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. All right, so the Most High is our husband. He's our ultimate husband, but Yahweh Shai is also the husband. It tells you in Revelation how, you know, he's coming back. Talks about how the 144,000 are like a bride. Oh, matter of fact, that's a couple things that come to mind. Revelation 14, and let's go to Revelation 21. Revelation 21 and 1. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. Matter of fact, let me start at Revelation 14. Let's go there. This is Revelation 4:14. And I'm going to start at 1 and jump down. And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on the Mount Zion. All right. Remember we read earlier, Mount Zion was, you know, the daughter of Zion was compared, you know, it was like a comely and delicate woman. The lamb represents Yahweh Shai. And with him, 144,000 having his father's name written on their foreheads. These are those men, all right? This is Yahweh Shai with 144,000, which are going to be the prophets. And I heard a voice from heaven as the voice of, let me jump down to verse 4. These are they which were not defiled with women. So these men were not defiled with other women, which in this sense, the women represent other strange doctrines. All right, because all the doctrines of these world, the different philosophies and doctrines, these things are likened to women, strange women. All right, they seduce you in the mind, and then they take you, you know, and you start worshiping these things. It eventually goes back to idolatry, because it basically takes you away from the Most High. All right, so Revelation 14 and 4, these are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed among men, being the first fruits unto the Most High and to the Lamb. All right. So with that, let's go to Revelation 21. And I saw a new heaven. All right, now this is after the destruction. This is when the elect get beamed up. You know, the missiles done destroyed Babylon. These different nations don't want the war. The chip is all in the earth enforced. All right, Revelation 21:1. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. This is John. All right, this is Apostle John on the Isle of Patmos having a vision. He said he saw a new heaven and a new earth. He saw a new world, man. He saw a new, like the earth was different, man. It was refreshed. Matter of fact, I think that word new there is kainos. Yeah, kainos, which means refreshed when you go into it. New, especially in freshness. All right, so it's going to be a refresh, man. New. Recently made, fresh, recent. Yeah, it's going to be a new dominion, man. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. Yeah, Esau is going to get taken down, and there ain't going to be no more of the heathens in rulership. All right, and I, John, or Yochanan in the Hebrew, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from the Most High out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. So he saw these Israelites coming down off the chariots. All right, and it says prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. All right, so that woman, all right, because we went into that word betrothed, right, belonging to someone. The elect belong to Yahawashah. Let's get that. Let's see. Yeah, John 18:9. Let's get that. John 18:9. No, that's not the one I want. John 17:24. Father, I will that they also whom thou hast given me, which are the elect, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundation of the earth. I'm going to jump up a little bit. I'm going to read the NLT. Starting at verse 20, John 17:20. I am praying not only for these disciples, but also for all who will ever believe in me through their message. The Lord is praying for who? The prophets and those who are receiving the testimony out of the mouth of the prophets. Verse 21, I pray that they will all be one, just as you and I are one. As you are in me, Father, and I am in you, and may they be in us, so that the world will believe you sent me. I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. I am in them, and you are in me. May they experience such perfect unity that the world would know that you sent me and that you love them as much as you love me. Father, I want these whom you have given me, the elect, to be with me where I am. Then they can see all the glory you gave me because you love me even before the world began. I'm going to finish reading it out. Oh, righteous Father, the world doesn't know you, but I do. And these disciples know you sent me. I have revealed you to them, and I will continue to do so. Then your love for me will be in them, and I will be in them. And the Lord is in us. He's with us. All right, the Lord is working with us today. And Lord willing, we are these 144,000 men. Let's go back to, what was we at? I think I was at Revelation 14. Yeah, Revelation 14. No, Salakia. But look at verse 3. and they sung it as it were a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders. And no man could learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. Alright, this is the, you know, the ones that are betrothed to Yah by Shemei Oshai. This is who the Lord is praying for. Okay, so let's go back to Revelation 21. Alright, 21 and 2, and I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from the Most High out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. That heaven represents above. So these men are going to be descending from above. Okay, and these men, this is the Lord's woman here, man. Going back to Isaiah 54 and 5, for thy maker is thy husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. He's redeeming us through Yahawashah, the God of the whole earth, shall he be called. For the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahawashah, have called thee as a woman forsaken and grieved in spirit, and a wife of youth when thou wast refused, saith thy God. For a small moment have I forsaken thee, but with great mercies will I gather thee. And right now we in the stages of the gathering, and the Lord is gathering us through the word, which is being preached to the four corners by way of the internet. Alright. Verse 8, in a little wrath I hid my face from thee for a moment, but with everlasting kindness will I have mercy on thee, saith the Lord thy Redeemer. Alright, and that mercy is coming. Alright. You know, we finna go through dark days, you know, the great tribulation, but the Lord is going to get his elect through it. All right, same way he got Yahawashah through his dark moment, through his, you know, his time of tribulation, you know, in the Garden of Gethsemane when he wanted the apostles to stay up with him and, you know, they kept falling asleep. You know, he prayed to the Father to take the cup with him and tell you how it was an angel that came and strengthened him. Right, same thing is going to happen with the elect, man. The elect are going to be strengthened because the angels are with us. You know, they're keeping charge over us. All right, so, you know, we are that damsel, Lord willing. We are that elect that's crying out, you know, that's not about to let this sicko, you know, penetrate us and have his way with us, man. And the Lord is about to take his ass down, man, because as we read in the law, you know, when the damsel will cry out, you know, that the man will be getting put to death, man, and the 2/3 about to get put to death too. So, you know, Lord willing, this was edifying. I know I was all over the place, but you know, it was just the spirit just had me, you know, going here and there and everywhere. But Lord willing, you were edified as I was, and I want to give all praises again to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushah, Bashem, Harukah, Kodash. Until the next lesson, I say Shalom.